Welcome back, friends. Now let us do a very important topic. Let us see about the types of partnership firms. So broadly speaking, there are three types of partnership firms or three categories of partnership firms according to time limits, according to liability, and according to registrations. Okay, so according to time limit, there are three types of partnership firm: partnership at will, term partnership, and partnership for a specific work. According to liability, we have a partnership firm with limited liability and a partnership firm with unlimited liability. So we have at will, term, specific work. That's time limit partnership. Liability, we have unlimited liability and limited liability partnership firm. And according to registration, we have a registered partnership firm and we have an unregistered partnership firm. So let us talk of according to time limit. So according to time limit, the first type of partnership firm is partnership at will. In this type of partnership firm, the lifespan of firm, means firm kab tak rahega, it depends upon the wishes of the partner. इसलिए will बोलते ना. So there is no time limit. जब तक partner चाहेंगे तब तक वो partnership firm चालू रहेगा. That so the firm will exist until there is unity and agreement among the partners. But if any one of the partner wishes to dissolve the firm, that if any partner wishes to dissolve the firm, then according to law, by giving notice, he can bring about the dissolution of the firm. So, jab tak partners chahenge, tab tak partnership firm chalu rahega. Once any partner wishes to dissolve or come out, the partnership firm is dissolved and the new firm is to be established. Second is term partnership. When in partnership deed, the time limit of partnership is mentioned, then it is called term partnership. So after completion of time limit, the firm is dissolved automatically. Yeah, but if partners agree, then the time limit can be extended further also. So it may be for 5 years, 10 years, or they may come together for a particular period of time. And once that time dissolves is over, the firm is dissolved, or they can apply for extension. And third is partnership firm for a specific work. According to partnership deed, when the partnership firm is established for completing a specific job only, then it is called partnership firm for specific work. So after completion of that work, the firm is dissolved automatically. Right? Let's take an example. In Surat, there are two big building groups, Raj Group and Green Group. Now suppose for a particular construction site or for a large project, Raj and Green Group come together and they take a joint project. So what they'll do now, they'll establish a partnership firm for a specific work. Let's say they take Project Atlantis. So they are going to build a big building called Atlantis and it will be a joint venture. So they form a partnership firm called Raj Green Group, right? So they combine themselves. And that partnership firm is only for Atlantis. So it will be Raj Green Atlantis Project Partnership, right? As soon as the Atlantis project is over, that partnership is now broken. So they come together for a specific work only. Okay. Now, second type of partnership was according to liability. We have talked of liability. If you have limited liability, then you are not bound to pay the debts which the firm is incurred. If you have unlimited liability, then the partner is bound to pay the debt of the firms also. So a partnership firm with limited liability is a special type of partnership firm where one partner or one or more partners can be excluded, right? Or excluding one partner firm, all other partners' liability can be kept limited. So let us say, to help one friend start his business, three other friends join him. द थ्री फ्रेंड्स आर फ्रॉम डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड्स, दे टेल दिस फ्रेंड कि ओके वी विल सपोर्ट यू, वी विल गिव यू फाइनेंस, वी विल गिव यू इनपुट्स फ्रॉम टाइम टू टाइम, बट वी विल एक्ट लाइक स्लीपिंग पार्टनर्स. सो यू रन योर पार्टनरशिप फर्म, यू रन द बिजनेस, एंड इन प्रॉफिट्स बिकॉज वी हैव इन्वेस्टेड आवर नेम एंड आवर मनी, वी विल टेक सम अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट. बट सपोज देयर इज अ लॉस और देयर इज अ लायबिलिटी विच यू हैव टू पे, वी आर नॉट लायबल because we are not taking part in the day-to-day business. So, in such a case, a limited liability partnership firm can be opened where one partner has unlimited liability and other partners have limited liability. Okay, so that is always possible. It is not possible to open a partnership firm where all members have limited liability. That is not possible. At least one should have unlimited liability. He is the person responsible. Second is a partnership firm with unlimited liability. All the partners have unlimited liability. Okay, all partners have unlimited liability. So if the debts of the firm increase more than asset of the firm, then each partner has to pay the debt of business even by selling their personal properties. Okay, now in the third type of partnership firm, according to registration, is it a registered partnership firm or is an unregistered partnership firm? So the partnership firm which is registered, the partnership firm which is registered with the registrar of firms is called a registered or registered partnership firm. And the advantage of this registered partnership firm is that you can approach the court of law for the recovery of debt from a third party or person. So it is not compulsory to register a partnership firm, but it is definitely advisable because a registered partnership firm has two main advantages. One is that you can approach the court of law for recovery of debt from a third party also, that's number one. And second, when any disputes rises among the partners, as your partnership firm is registered, all the rules and regulations and the structure of the firm is already registered with the government, right? There is credibility, so you can go for legal recourse. You can approach the court also for to settle disputes among the partners. So that's a very important aspect because at times there may be misunderstanding, there may be mistrust among partners after some years, and someone must be wants to leave, or there may be a miscommunication. All this can be settled out if the partnership firm is registered. Even at times of succession, if two good friends start a partnership firm and one of them dies, it may be very hard for the child's that person's son or higher to be on same terms as their parents. Like it happens in many places, okay, two brothers start a business and they grow the business, make it big. After the brothers, their sons take over the business. Now the sons of both the brothers now are managing the business, but the sons are not so in tune or compatible with each other. So the two sons, my cousins, start fighting among each other. And at that time, the partnership firm has to broke or has to dissolve. If it is registered, it is very easy to separate it out. Unregistered partnership firm is not registered with the registrar of firms, right? So it is difficult to recover their debts through the court of law in such a case. That is why it is advisable to always register a partnership firm. Okay, so we talk of the type of partnership firms, the three different headings and the various types. Very, very important answer. Please do learn this. Next video, we will cover the registration process of a partnership firm. What is involved, what is required while registering the partnership firm. So meet you in the next video. Bye.